It was hard to believe how the German government, German people could do those things.
We need art in order to exist.
This is part of civilization, and this is what we're fighting for.
It was an honor. I'm very happy that I was able to participate in that.
Based on someone very real, a guy named Harry Ettlinger, who is alive.
Private, what's that sign say?
Storage.
The arc of that character and what happens to that character is fairly accurate.
I was born in Germany into the Jewish faith, and under Hitler, he was on his way to get rid of all Jews in the world. And that led to my folks' conclusion that life in Germany for a Jew was no longer possible.
When did you leave Germany?
1938. Yeah, I was 13.
Did your family go with you?
Yeah, my parents. My grandfather stayed behind.
I was 18 years old. I was drafted. Every boy my age, if he was physically healthy, joined the armed forces of this country at that particular time. On my 19th birthday, I found myself on one of 100 trucks to go up to fight in the Battle of the Bulge. I got pulled out along with two other guys. 3 months later, they had changed me from an infantryman to an interpreter, and I was on my way to the Nuremberg trial. But on the way, somebody came to me and said, I understand you knew how to speak and write German. They could use in that office. That was my entry into the monuments.
I got involved with the army when I was drafted by the United States government. I served in the medical department of the army. Monuments group stole me away from the medical department. That's all right, I wasn't objecting. But I was surprised that they had chosen me because I'm not all that connected with artistic things. But my colleagues, if you call them that, they were more my superiors than colleagues. They were art professors in military uniform. I admired them for their expertise, but I didn't share it with them. It wasn't against it, it's just that I didn't know about these things. I asked stupid questions and they gave me brilliant answers. I learned a great deal from these experts. I began to think that art and management of art and museums and so forth was a very important thing.
The war in Europe ended May the 8th. I was now a first lieutenant. I was assigned to Alt-Aussee, Austria, early June, with 30 men, 30 soldiers, to prevent anybody from going in the mine.
I was recruited by Christopher Norris, who, when I was a student at the Courtauld, he used to come and lecture us on Rubens. It was at the end of the war, and I was working in the Ministry of Information. He suggested I might join the Monuments and Fine Arts, and I was bored at that point by my work in the ministry, and so I went. I was put in a relatively undamaged area of Germany, but our monuments people on the ground in Hamburg, Düsseldorf, and Münster, and so forth, they were dealing with the actual difficulties.
Got a chance of getting a ride into Les Eaux?
Not a chance, Lieutenant.
You luck finding some radios?
No, sir.
The monuments officers had many concerns, and perhaps paramount at the outset was whether or not anybody would listen to them.
From the beginning of the monuments operations in Italy and so forth, there was always a lot of tension between the needs of the military and the requirements of the monuments officers.
Colonel, if you would just read the orders.
I'll tell you what these orders say. Don't knock out
Colonel,
old
building.
Do not interrupt me, Lieutenant.
Eisenhower did say that they are to be given every sort of help. But to begin with, I think they didn't fit in with the army.
I think that went well.
Looks like we're walking.
Much to their surprise, it was resisted only mildly at the beginning, and pretty quickly they found soldiers that had overheard these discussions later on would come up to them months later and say, hey, how are we doing? Have we saved any churches? Have we found any paintings?
It was happy that they were doing that for the United States government and the people of the United States. And I was happy to be sharing that operation.
Jim Rohmer took me to a jail in Munich where we interrogated the personal photographer and art agent for Adolf Hitler. That got me, let's say, more acquainted with what was going on. Later in May and early June, I went to the castle of Neuschwanstein, where they had shipped the belongings of the wealthy Jewish Rothschild family. All kinds of art, furniture, and household things.
It was an enormous operation getting these pictures and statues and so forth identified and connected with the place they had been stolen from.
In the course of the last few months of the war, they started to find these salt mines and caves filled with thousands of paintings, millions of library books and other cultural treasures.
I went into the mine one day. There were numerous wooden racks of paintings. Oh, many, many of them.
These salt mines were huge chambers, 60 feet wide, 40 feet high, and a mile long, 65 degrees Fahrenheit. Humidity, 40 to 60%. Ideal working conditions.
It was like walking into a museum. The photographer took our picture. This was the famous Madonna and Child by Michelangelo. That was the prize. Then there was another picture of him, Adoration of the Mystic Land by Van Eyck. Of course, we were amazed to see what we were doing, trying to make right out of wrong by returning these to their rightful owners.
My trouble was, on the whole, simply dealing with the sort of bureaucratic bothers. There was no transport, there was no materials for packing or for mending. Women were not allowed to drive alone with a German driver. VIPs had to have an English driver and a better car, and then they were always breaking down, and then one had to get onto the transport people. I mean, I've spent a lot of my time on that sort of rubbish.
Well, there's a famous museum there.
What city?
Karlsruhe. Had one of Rembrandt's self-portraits.
Oh, I see you were born to be a monuments man. I've never seen that painting.
No, me neither.
There was a Rembrandt self-portrait in a museum in Karlsruhe. He'd never seen it.
I don't think you've been properly introduced.
The museum was three blocks away from where I lived.
Sam, that's your neighbor, Mr. Rembrandt. You tell your grandfather when you see him.
Nice to meet you.
That painting is the pride and joy of the art museum in Karlsruhe to this particular day. To me, it was part of the job to get things done.
I felt elated that I helped to be a part of restoring things to the rightful owners. Sure, it made me feel good.
I've often thought that MFANA should have had more recognition in the years since the Second World War.
I think it is very important to get the interest of a lot of people who wouldn't be bothered to think about politics or economics or something, but they realize that this is one of the costs of enmity and dangers of war.
Picasso.
We believed what we were doing was the right thing to do. Instead of spoil the war like everybody had done, all nations had done prior to that. We had the concept and the ability and the workforce to give it back whenever possible.
No one in this country really knew about who the Monuments Men were. The first thing we did was go to Congress and lobby the Senate and the House of Representatives to honor and recognize all 350 men and women from 13 countries. And that was a unanimous resolution passed on June 6th, anniversary of D-Day in 2007.
Harry Ettlinger came to my office and talked his story, and it was so wonderful. And his congressman, Rodney Frelinghuysen, said, Kay, I've known that man for years, and I've never heard that story. And I said, yes, that's why they call it the greatest generation, because they did heroic things like that and then didn't talk about it a lot.
Thank you for having the wisdom, the culture, and the awareness of this very important part of preservation for the world for the future. Thank you.
We were honored that we're here in both the Congress and in the White House by the president. For an ordinary guy like me with an unforgettable experience.
This is what is important in the world, isn't it? It's what makes life really valuable. Music and literature and art and painting, the creative results of interesting, sensitive people.
I'm very happy that we've got a lot of art objects sent back where they were supposed to be.
I am proud to be a monuments man.
To the monuments man.
To the monuments.
To the monuments.